हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम आहेर अलका फ्रॉम आरबीएनबी कॉलेज रामपुर। आई एम फ्रॉम फिजिक्स डिपार्टमेंट। टुडे वी स्टडी द न्यू चैप्टर सुपरपोजिशन ऑफ वेव्स। नाउ सी, इन द सुपरपोजिशन ऑफ वेव वी फर्स्ट सी द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन ऑफ द वेव्स। द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन ऑफ वेव्स इज व्हेन टू or more waves traveling through medium, each wave produces its own displacement at that point independent on the other wave. The resultant displacement at that point is equal to vector sum of the individual displacement at that point. See, the principle of superposition of wave, when there are two or more waves traveling through medium, they interfere with each other at a point, it produces its displacement at that point, and the resultant displacement, it is the vector sum of these individual displacement. Let y is the resultant displacement, and due to superposition of wave, it is y1 plus y2. Here, y1 is the displacement due to one wave, y2 is the displacement due to another wave, and it is the vector sum, and this is the principle of the superposition of wave. Now, we see that interference. The interference, it is the physical effect, due to superposition of the waves. See, interference, it is the physical effect due to superposition of wave when the two waves are in phase or out of phase. Now, here we consider the interference, that is physical effect due to the superposition of wave. There are two types of interference. The first is constructive interference. And the second type, destructive interference. There are two types of interference, constructive interference and destructive interference. In constructive interference, see, there are few points to remember. That is, when the two or more waves, for example, this is the one wave. Now, having displacement y1, the another wave, this is the another wave. Now, this wave having displacement y2. This displacement y2. Here again, the displacement of this wave is y1. The displacement of this wave is y2. Again, this is the y1 and this is the y2. Now see, here the resultant displacement, we know y is equal to y1 plus y2. Then the displacement of first wave, it is like this, and displacement of another wave, it is like this. The two waves are in phase. That is, the crest of one wave, it is coincide with crest of another wave. The resultant displacement, it is maximum. This type of interference, it is called as constructive interference. See, in case of transverse wave, In case of transverse wave, the crest is overlap or crest is coincide with crest, trough is coincide with trough. The two waves are in phase. The two waves are in phase. The resultant displacement, it is maximum. The resultant displacement is maximum. Then the resultant displacement is maximum. The type or the interference is constructive interference. It is the constructive interference. In case of longitudinal wave, then the longitudinal wave consists of compression, alternate compression and rarefaction. Now, when the two waves are in phase, that is compression of one wave, it is coincide with compression of another wave, the resultant intensity of sound, it is maximum. This type of interference, it is constructive interference. In case of rarefaction, that is rarefaction of one wave is coincide with rarefaction of another wave, the resultant displacement, it is maximum, resultant intensity of sound is maximum, and that waves are constructive or the interference is constructive interference. In both cases, we see that the two waves are in phase and the resultant intensity or resultant displacement is maximum. It is constructive interference. Now we see the destructive interference. In destructive interference, the two waves are out of phase. The two waves are out of phase. For example, here we consider the crest of one wave, one transverse wave is coincide with trough of another wave. Here the two waves are out of phase, that is there is a phase difference of pi. This type of wave, it is called as destructive interference. Now in destructive interference, the two waves are out of phase and the resultant intensity or the resultant displacement, it is vector sum of the displacement due to the other waves and y is equal to y1 minus y2. Here the displacement, it is minimum. The resultant displacement, it is minimum. In case of transverse wave, crest of one wave, it is coincide with trough of another wave. The resultant amplitude, resultant displacement, it is minimum. The two waves are out of phase, that is there is phase difference of pi, and the resultant density or the resultant intensity is minimum. It is called destructive interference. Now in case of longitudinal wave, we know that longitudinal wave consists of compression and rarefaction. In compression or at compression, air layers are more crowded, while at rarefaction, air layers are more separated. Now, in this case, when the two waves are out of phase, that is two longitudinal waves coincide with each other, that is compression of one wave, it is coincide with the refraction of another wave, the resultant intensity of sound is minimum and the two waves are out of phase. This type of interference, it is destructive interference. Now, these are, we see here, the principle of superposition of wave, then interference, that is the physical effect due to the superposition of wave, and then constructive interference, in constructive interference, the two waves are in phase, resultant amplitude is maximum, and this is the constructive interference. In case of destructive interference, the two waves are out of phase and the resultant displacement is minimum, resultant intensity of sound is minimum, and it is called as destructive interference. Now we see the expression for the analytical treatment for the superposition of two waves. Analytical treatment. Treatment for superposition of two waves. Now see here, two waves of same amplitude. Consider waves traveling through medium having same amplitude, having two waves having same amplitude, having different amplitudes, different amplitudes, and phi is the phase difference. It is also called as phase difference, it is also called as initial phase. Now consider two waves of different amplitude and different phase difference. Consider the first wave having the displacement y1 is equal to a sine omega t. A sine omega t. Another wave having the displacement y2 is equal to a1, it is a2 sine omega t plus phi. Consider the two waves having displacement y1 and y2. There are the phase differences, the amplitudes are different, phase differences are so different. Now a1 and a2 are the amplitudes, phi and it is for x is equal to 0, the initial phase is 0 here. Therefore, this is the equation for y1, this is the equation for y2. Consider two waves of different amplitude a1 and a2 and phase difference 0 and phi. Consider the displacement of wave which is starting from x is equal to 0, and this is the another wave, it is differ by phase phi. Now due to superposition of wave, the resultant displacement, it is y is equal to y1 plus y2. Substitute the value of y1 and y2. The y1 is a1 sine omega t plus a2 sine omega t plus phi. Now we use the trigonometric relation, that is sine a plus b. We have trigonometric relation. Trigonometric relation, that is sine a plus b is equal to sine a cos b plus cos a sine b. Using this relation, we expand this bracket. Therefore, we get y is equal to, we write this equation, that is a1 sin omega 2 sin omega t plus a2 sin omega t plus phi. Now expand this bracket, a1 sin omega t plus a2 into bracket sin of omega t cos phi plus cos omega t sin phi. Now multiply by a2, it becomes a1 sin omega t plus a2 into, multiply by a2, it is sin omega t cos phi plus a2 cos omega t sin phi. Now sin omega t is take common here, we get sin omega t is common, sin omega t is common here. Now it is a1 plus a2 cos phi, a2 cos phi plus a2 into sin phi cos omega t. Now substitute for this bracket cos phi and sin phi. Substitute a1 divided by a1 plus a2 cos phi is equal to a cos theta. Now for a2 sin phi is equal to a sin theta. Substitute here, we get y is equal to, now for this bracket we can substitute a cos theta sin omega t plus, in this bracket substitute a2 sin phi, that is a sin theta into cos omega t. Now take a is common, then we get sin omega t cos theta plus sin theta into cos omega t, which is the formula for sin omega t plus phi or theta. Now here y is equal to, y is equal to a into sin omega t plus phi or theta. This is the resultant displacement. This is the resultant displacement. Resultant displacement. In this resultant displacement, y is resultant displacement, a is resultant amplitude, omega is, it is the angular velocity, this is phi, it is the phase difference. Now this is the resultant amplitude, resultant displacement, and this equation represents that, which represents the resultant displacement performs simple harmonic motion, simple harmonic motion. Now we find the resultant, we find the resultant amplitude, resultant amplitude. Consider the equation, that is consider these two equations, these two equation, the consider two equations, that is a1 is equal to, consider this equation, that is a1 plus a2 cos phi is equal to a cos phi, and another equation a2 sin phi is equal to a sin phi. Squaring and adding, we get squaring and adding. Square this term, that is a1 plus a2 cos phi is equal to square this term plus square this a2 sin phi bracket square is equal to square this is a square cos square phi plus a square sin square phi. Solving the equation, we get a square cos square phi plus a square sin square phi is equal to square this bracket a1 plus a2 cos phi bracket square plus a2 sin a2 square sin square phi. Then a square is common, cos square phi plus sin square phi is equal to square this bracket a1 square plus a2 square cos square phi plus 2 a1 a2 cos phi plus a2 square sin square phi. Now cos square phi plus sin square phi, it is equal to 1, and we can write a square is equal to, it is a1 square. Now in this case a2 square is common, in bracket cos square phi plus sin square phi plus 2 a1 a2 cos phi. Now again sin cos square phi plus sin square phi, it is equal to 1. We can write a square is equal to a1 square plus a2 square plus 2 a1 a2. That is a is equal to, we can write the resultant amplitude, it is a1 plus a2 plus 2 a1 a2. A1 a2 cos phi. This is the expression for resultant amplitude. This is the expression for resultant amplitude. We see the cases of the amplitude in next lecture. Thank you.